His short program here in Lausanne, another thing that has made Elvis Stoiko very angry. He skated a clean program as opposed to what he did a year ago in Edmonton, but still the judges put him in fourth place.
The music, Dragon Heart, and look at how long he waits before he begins movement.
And during the practices today before the competition, Elvis did what I call a visualization run-through, where you don't jump very much, but you go through the whole program and skate it and mark it and visualize your jumps in each position.
That wait must seem like a lifetime.
I'd want to get going.
At least on paper, you'd have to say he's planning maybe the toughest program technically we've ever seen in skating.
Definitely, definitely.
Beautiful triple flip. He takes his time. He has a clear picture of the role he's playing. He doesn't rush. There's a nice sense of clarity about his skating. And if he's going to do a quadruple jump, it will come up right here.
A quadruple toe loop, triple toe loop. The first time that combination has been achieved. Good for you, Elvis.
He was the first man to pull it off in competition, and now he becomes the first man to do it at the World Championships.
Uncontrolled on the landing.
So far, we have yet to see a flawless program. Right now, Vyacheslav Zagorodnik of Ukraine leads. Ilya Kulik is in second place. And Andrei Vlashenko in third, just ahead of Michael Weiss of the U.S. And of course, Eldridge still to come. He skates next. And Alexei Yagudin, the young Russian.
Two hardest combinations performed in the competition yet. And maybe even for the rest of the night.
Taken with a great deal of ease. Best moment by any means.
As opposed to a year ago, Elvis is both alive and in the building here in Lausanne. The 94 and 95 world champion. Coming up next, the ladies' short program as the World Figure Skating Championships presented by MasterCard continue here on ESPN.